morning, Pisces. How are you? Well, good morning for me. I've been doing these readings quite early every morning, so let's go ahead and get started. I don't have a lot to say, so we're going to go ahead and start with your love reading and then move right into your general reading for March 2016. So here we go. Pisces, here we go. Love reading for March, this one, of 2016. Well, it all seems quite romantic, actually. Good start for the reading. I'm wondering if right now, Pisces, you aren't experiencing something new, right? Something new coming in your life, in your life, not necessarily a person, but some new thing or some new interest or passion, something that you've decided to really take hold of and move forward, right? And if not, I think something will be coming in quite soon. And it might be related to someone, right? Here is someone new coming in. If you're in a relationship, if you are married, this can indicate your partner coming in and making some sort of an offering for you, right? Some sort of proposal, some sort of, not proposal for marriage, but proposal that you do something together or go somewhere, or, you know, he or she might express something to you that might be somewhat unexpected, okay? Oh. And if you are, sorry, I just burned my tongue on my teeth. If you are single, this can indicate someone new coming in. Now, I do think you have a lot of like red wings here, angels and red wings, and it's going to all be very romantic, I think, and temperance. I think this person will bring you peace. I think you are bringing yourself peace. You have a very peaceful air about you. Here you are, the Empress, okay? Very calm, very collected, very ready. I think ready for something significant, ready for something promising. This person, I believe, will connect, you know, well, the Two of Cups is connecting you two. So very like-minded people, okay? You might be a little bit more ready than they are, so it might be kind of a slow process, but ultimately, you know, a good a strong ability for you two to communicate, an ability for you two to be on the same page, to run parallel, to connect with one another on significant and substantial issues, substantial areas of your life, okay? So maybe not the most, I mean, it can be soulmate qualities there. I'm not getting the lovers, so maybe a compatibility, more just compatibility, I would say. And something that makes sense, something that that fits really well, okay? It might not give you all the butterflies in the world, but ultimately, it's something that could be long-lasting, right? It has the potential for longevity. And I think this truly is a time when you, Pisces, are allowing the universe to sort of take the wheel and drive. And we all have control of our own lives up to a certain extent. And then up to that point, once we hit that point, the universe has to kick in. The universe has to intervene. You know, there are so many things that we cannot control. You know, the weather, other people's actions, the way other people feel, the way other people drive. Though, I mean, there's so many things that are out of your realm of control. So this is a point in time where that wheel is spinning, right? That wheel of fortune is spinning, and you're going to have some sort of universal intervention, right? Something is going to feel like it truly was just blessed. You were just blessed, and something so random and something so out of the ordinary, I think. Now, this person might have, you know, the Five of Swords. I don't like this card. The fives always trip me up. If you've been listening to me for a while, I express my dislike of the fives. And it's not because of the meaning of the card. You know, we all have some trials and stuff, but I don't like it because it's so out of place in the reading, right? All these cards are so wonderful. And then there's this one card that sort of is in here that kind of plays the devil's advocate a little bit and just says that perhaps there might be some air of like arguments or some air of like an ego, or you know, perhaps there's some like empty battle that's being won, or some bad habit that is recurring, right? And I don't know exactly what that is for you, but if this person fits an MO, that might be, you know, some sort of a bad habit, or if you have a habit of starting new things, starting new projects and never finishing them, that could be, you know, something here. A bad habit of maybe even, despite obvious compatibility, despite obvious connection that you feel with this person, if this person doesn't meet your exact specific standards, maybe you don't take him or her as seriously as maybe you should. You know, this is truly an intervention from the universe. Something is coming to you on purpose. And ignoring that or not accepting it or looking at it as a blessing might be, I'm not going to say it's bad for you, but it just might not be what the universe wants. Okay, so again, I don't really like this card so much. I think it's just coming up as a preemptive piece of advice, right? Just don't fight it. Just allow it to come in. Allow it to bring you blessings. Allow it to bring you happiness. Allow it to just be good. Allow it to just be something good in your life, okay? Now, I think you are, you know, the Empress, the Hermit. I think you're going through some, maybe a life-changing phase a little bit, like a phase of restructuring what it is that you want in your life, restructuring your ideas, your overall goals in your life. What is it that you are seeking in a partner? All sorts of different things. And that can cause you to maybe be a little bit withdrawn, and again, might cause you to maybe not recognize the potential in this person or in this offering from your significant other. But ultimately, the Magician, again, it's going to be something very obvious that comes in. It's not going to be some subdued, secretive, read between the lines type of thing. I mean, this is a prominent force that is going to be in your face, it's going to be obvious, and despite your retreatedness, okay, you are going to have something maybe shake up your world a little bit. Something new is going to be beginning. Okay. Now, I've been doing something a little bit different in these readings. This is a very standard spread, this nine card spread. It's called the Spirit Guide Spread. And none of the, there are different ways to read this. Sometimes the positions have specific meanings. The way I do it allows me more flexibility just to flow and and to read the cards as I feel inspired to do so. But, you know, I like it, but I decided I wanted to pull out more cards at the end. So I'm going to start pulling three cards instead of just one, because I feel like it's just provides a little bit more emphasis on certain ideas, and it provides a little bit more information for you. So let's just go ahead and shuffle a little bit. Well, I love the Page of Wands and the Ace of Wands, and I'm happy that there wasn't necessarily a reinforcement of the Five of Swords. I think that really just was coming out as just a little bit of a preemptive warning, just to watch behavior and to watch and to be alert of the way you respond to certain things. But ultimately, here you are, a beautiful character, someone who is warm and inviting and genuine, and again, ready. I think you're ready for something real, ready for something substantial, and I think truly this could be someone substantial in your life, someone who is becomes a prominent figure, you know, a husband or a wife. Potential for that. Don't hold me to that, but potential for that. And again, transformation, Page of Wands. You are changing. You are morphing. You are, there's a new adventure in front of you, and you're feeling curious and anxious about it. You know, you're like totally sitting on the edge of your seat, ready to go. I mean, like literally on the edge of your seat, ready to go, ready to get up and go, and to find and to create a relationship, a, you know, something real. I can't think of anything else to describe it. Just something real, something substantial. And I see you as being a very strong person, someone who is comfortable in his or her own right, right? You have your own things going. You're an independent force. You can stand on your own, no problem. But maybe prefer the company of someone else. Maybe prefer the benefits of being in a relationship. Right, and I think that is coming your way. Someone, something quite with the potential to be long lasting for sure. And I think their offering, their entry in your life. Now, this may or may not be someone that you know. It could be someone new coming in, or when it's a king, sometimes it is someone that has a presence in our life already. Could be an earth sign. I feel like I'm leaning more towards the earth sign, because even though this is not, you know, this is the card of Virgo, this is, I think, the card of Libra, I believe. But either way, you showing up here, and even to me, this is also a very earthy energy. I feel like the compatibility, like I said, will be quite strong on more practical levels, not the hypersexual, over romantic type of way, but a relationship that makes sense, a relationship that you connect and like things fall into place, pieces of the puzzle start to fit, and you click very well, you communicate very well, you can sort of anticipate the needs of the other person very well, and that I think is more of a formula, as boring as it might sound, it's more of a formula for a, like I said, a long-lasting connection. So let's go ahead and do your general reading. for March. Okay, Pisces. Now, I have a little bit of arthritis in my hands, and this morning I woke up and they were feeling quite sore. Actually, all week they've been quite sore, so my shuffling is a little bit difficult for me this morning. So, let's see. And the top one again. Here we go, that idea of balance coming in for you. Oh, you know, this has been happening. At one point I accidentally shuffled in, I think, a reading upside down. I read reversals from time to time, more so on my personals if I'm feeling the mood for it, but for these I purposely chose to read all upright, but if I accidentally did it, I'm going to just keep it that way. So let's move into this reading, because it's got some tougher energies, okay? The Nine of Swords, Nine of Wands, Chariot, Seven, you know, a couple sevens coming in here, but ultimately a really beautiful, I think, entry. Or, I'm sorry, like a, this might be something that you're going through more right now, or is going to be coming into your life just relatively shortly, and I think it will be short-lived. I don't think it's going to be this huge, you know, affecting type of thing, right? Nine of Swords, Nine of Wands. Your mind is very active, okay? Even here, Seven of Wands. Your mind is spinning, your heart is spinning, you're feeling very closed off, you're feeling maybe a little bit defensive, and it can be difficult for other people. This is your energy though, I'm seeing. It can be difficult for other people to penetrate these energies, right? To get through those swords, to get through those wands. And other people can be very perceptive, especially on the subconscious level. And they know that you, and this could actually have something to do with that Five of Swords, right? Maybe that's more the energy that's coming out, is an idea of protection. And that is what is maybe causing you to, like, again, not recognize or not allow someone so wonderful, has the potential to be so wonderful, into your life. Have you been hurt in the past? Most likely. I think we all have. But don't allow that to affect the potential of something that has, you know, so much beauty and so much promise, okay? This isn't intentionally another love reading, okay? I just think you have prominent love energies and they're coming out in both. But this even can affect other areas of your life, right? Even this chariot, all areas of your life. Can you see that? Let me pull it down a little bit. I'm sorry. There we go. You know, when you have this mindset and you have these energies around you, it can be difficult to work with someone like that. You know, someone who might have a little bit of a biting tongue, someone who feels confused, who feels torn, someone who is on guard and defensive all the time, right? It can be difficult for others to cooperate with you and to even make you happy. Right? These are so deep inside of your mind, so deep inside of your heart, and even these Seven of Cups, feelings of confusion, feelings of like, where do I go? Is this the right person? Is this the right path? Is this the right passion? Is this, you know, is this the right decision? And constantly asking yourself, is this right? Is this what you're meant to do? Is this what you're meant to be? Da, 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 da. You know, so many questions that you have yourself in your own life, and so much push-pull, right? You know, the heart versus the head. Although I see the balance coming out, okay? Temperance. I see that all of these comes to a close, right? It reaches that equilibrium on some level. It comes together and allows you to breathe. You know, these are very suffocating energies for you. Especially this one here. It is very suffocating. It's very overwhelming to experience so much cloudiness, you know, so much emotional cloudiness, and not to be able to really see your way out. Now, this in reverse for me says, you know, right side up, it's, you know, maybe not being able to see truth, not being able to understand the way you feel, not being able to see the information that is right at hand. And when it's reversed, for me, I think that energy is lessened, okay? It's not as strong, it's weakened, which means you might be coming out of that. You might be in the process of removing the blindfold so that you can see the truths. Truths about the way someone else feels about you, truths about the direction that you're taking in your life, truths about others around you and about your situation in general. And ultimately, Page of Wands coming out again, there is a new beginning in store for you, for sure. There is an opportunity that presents itself. Ace of Cups, no doubt about it. We had the Ace of Wands in the last reading as well. And I think you, Queen of Cups and Ace of Cups, you come to some level of understanding about what that is. You come to some level of acceptance about what that is. You put your swords and wands and cups to rest, and you just allow yourself to go with the flow. Just go with it. Don't fight it. Again, that Five of Swords energy is coming out. So, you know, what is it that you're fighting? What are you trying to protect? What are you trying to keep secret? You know, there's no need. You are a wonderful person, but you feel things deeply. Your emotions run deep. They run thick. They're prominent. And sometimes that can just get you a little bit overworked emotionally and mentally. But again, I see that coming to rest. So let's go ahead and pull some additional cards for you. Top one keeps speaking to me, so I'm just gonna go with it. Okay, well, I do feel, you know, There is opportunity, okay? Three of Wands, Ace of Cups, Page of Wands. There is opportunity for you to move on. There is opportunity for you to embark upon something new and exciting, okay? And this can also indicate some communication coming in. Now, there's a lot of... don't quote me on this. I'm not an astrologer, so I don't really know. But I think there's like a new moon happening now or soon. That's really like a new moon of truth from what I remember hearing. And that concept, whether that's real or not, that concept is really ringing true for a lot of signs this month. Truth and information and things coming to light. And our minds, you know, whether the truth is a good thing or a bad thing, you know, it is up in the air. But ultimately for you, I see it as being a good thing, okay? Truth perhaps about the way someone feels about you. Truth perhaps about the way you feel about someone else. And some level of vulnerability as well. This energy, interesting, it's coming out as the Knight of Wands. I think this is that same Knight of Cups coming in. So he's got a well-rounded, you know, representation, the pentacles, the cups, and now wands. So someone who is very intriguing, right? Someone who's very well-rounded personality-wise. He's not just a pentacle, not just a cup, not just a wand, but he's got, he or she, I'm sorry, they have a lot of personality versatility and can take on different airs and match you in different ways. You know, they might be quite malleable. You know, it sort of means that they might have planets in different, all sorts of different things, right? Their Venus, their Mercury, their Mars, they're probably well-rounded in that regard and can cater to you on many different levels, and thence, you know, and therefore that's that compatibility that we talked about. Okay, and I think this is someone very interested in you. I think there's a real offering. I think he or she will come in and be very focused on you and make that offering and reveal to you the way they feel about you, and make no qualms about that. You know, it will be very genuine, it will be very honest. Accept their honesty, accept their genuine nature, because the compatibility is there. Like I said, you have the Two of Cups, so you have that on your side, it's working with you. You might be working against yourself a little bit, but I see you overcoming that, I see you accepting this as something good, okay? So, two love readings for you, essentially. Sometimes you can't help when you have a lot of focus in that love department. You know, other signs this month had a lot of career things going, so it does vary. It's not just always two love readings. It does vary. So anyway, I wish you nothing but the best. Good luck. Thank you for watching in, and I will see you next month. Thanks.